this was a long, long remove from the Me Too movement. And back then, I mentioned it was a man's business, very much so then. Did you deal with a lot of that backstage?
No, Sean, you know, God, and, you know, we worked together, but yet, you know, you were in a different area, and they really didn't. When this stuff came, oh, gosh, I know you were with us, because Linda came on one of the towns. It was in Hershey, Pennsylvania, and it was a big deal, this, you know, sexual harassment and anything, and they, as a big company, were trying to make sure they were on top of it, and Linda, mm-hmm. being who she is, she ran it, and she wanted to talk to Sherry and I and the Sewing Girls, and but she wanted to make sure there was not anything going on, being said that maybe we had, you know, hadn't felt like we could open up and talk to the men. And, I mean, it was about as far removed from us, that could be. In fact, I told them, I was like, Linda, if I didn't have sexual harassment, I would never get a compliment in this business. And I said, you can call it whatever you want, but very rarely, rarely would I get it. And it was later on from Kurt Henning, which is a dear friend, and he stood out and he'd say, hey, you're looking good tonight, or a gorilla would give me, you know, but that was a compliment. It was not like, hey, Buster, you know, shut up. It was your own peers telling you, hey, you look good. Never, because I mean, I didn't give them anything to look at anyway, but I didn't have anybody, there were stories out there, I'm sure somebody said, oh, she quit because Vince McMahon made a move on her or something. Never happened. Vince never even tried. I mean, there you go. That's the respect I know of him and how I know and would feel. Because the guys had wives, and then, you know, every night there is temptation on the road, and you see things, and you don't say anything. They have families. You don't say anything. You know how this goes anyway. It doesn't always happen in the wrestling business. It happens in offices and music, but everywhere. But, which is sad to say, that if that somebody wants to get somewhere, or that, you know, they hold your, hold that up as a ticket. And I never had that. Nor, of course, Sherry, most of the guys were afraid of her.
I was going to say, nobody would touch Sherry. She would have...
No, I told her one time, she really liked Hawk of Legion of Doom. It just liked him very well. She loved Joe, too, but Hegstrand was a different character. He was fun to be around with. He was constantly... joking and constantly telling Vince, you know, to us where Vince could go. And, you know, he eventually did tell Vince where to go, but he just was a character.
Yeah.
And Sherry, one night, we were all together, because it takes time. I mean, especially when, you know, that when we've had a long show and you go out afterwards and you have a couple of drinks to wind down. And I saw Sherry go after Mike, and Mike came up to me later on. Sherry went on to the bathroom, and Mike came up to me, and he said, hey, McGirt, would you please do me a favor and tell Sherry, don't kiss me ever again with a bunch of peanuts in her mouth. And I was like, oh, God, oh, Lord, oh, Lord. And so, I mean, Sherry was, you know, putting him on the...
He was being harassed.
Yeah. I'm going to save you from Sherry. And he's like, go in the bathroom and tell her now. Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, yeah. Oh, that one time that we were all out, and there was a gal that was up dancing, and she's pretty proud of herself. And she had a bathing suit on, but still, it was, you know, she's pretty proud. And you don't do that in front of Sherry. And not when Sherry had, you know, was in that mood. And she looked back at the lady and looked, and I thought, oh, dear. And, Sherry got up on there and started dancing, and the lady just danced right off and sat in the chair. But that was Sherry. She thought, Sherry wanted to take over the stage. So she did. But she was, there's one or two people that have said something so nasty and bad and saying, oh, about me and Sherry. I didn't ride with her. Right there, maybe the last, if she had a car, we were never riding alone. We also never shared a room together. And it's sad because we were to save money on her part and my part. But again, here we go with the connotation of the two women. And yep. Because we had to carve out our identities, and our identities wasn't in his bag. We were friends, but also too, you had to be careful because somebody would talk or say something that wasn't even true. So, yeah. You know, but we could, you know, we were still friends. Yeah. And that's crazy.